Possessed is basically a collection of seven stories. Okay. And somehow I have this idea that like demons and ghosts, they are less scary than human beings. Human beings are more crooked and wicked.
Okay. Yeah.
So all my stories, they like evolve around the human sentiments. Okay. With a paranormal twist in it.
Welcome back to SYWK podcast, where no topic is off limits. Since you all know how much I love horror and paranormal stuff, I have now built an interest in reading books related to it. Moreover, Indian horror stories. And that's why for today's episode, I have someone who has written his first book called Possessed and the Other Tales from the Dark. By profession, he is a teacher and he has also been writing plays for more than 20 years. He is the one and only Mr. Abhishek Kumar Singh. If you love horror like me, you should check out his book. I will leave all the details in my description. And if you would like to know more about the book and Mr. Abhishek's journey, listen till the end, since he himself has narrated a verse from his book which was quite scary. I got goosebumps myself. And if you enjoy the episode, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So welcome, Mr. Abhishek Kumar Singh. Welcome to my podcast channel, SYWK. So how are you, Mr. Abhishek?
I'm fine. Thank you, Dishman.
It is a pleasure, thanks, you know, to get you on board and talk about your book. But before we start, if you can give us an introduction to our listeners and tell us something more about yourself.
Okay, friends, like as you already know that my name is Abhishek and basically I'm a teacher.
Okay.
So I teach in a school and apart from this, I love writing. Okay.
Okay.
So from last 20 years, right from my college days, I had been writing plays and directing them.
Wow.
So that is how I came into writing, and mostly I have written number of plays, more of plays and less of stories. Now, for this, okay, is going to be my first book and first published book. So that is how it goes on.
If you can tell us something about this book.
Possessed is basically a collection of seven stories. Okay. And somehow I have this idea that like demons and ghosts, they are less scary than human beings. Human beings are more crooked and wicked.
Okay. Yeah.
So all my stories, they like evolve around the human sentiments. Okay. Mm-hmm. With a paranormal twist in it.
Oh, okay.
So like one or two of my readers, they were telling me that, sir, I have read 7 pages and till now I did not see anything related to paranormal. So I told you, just wait.
The suspense. Yeah.
Okay. The suspense. Because naturally, I simply write about ghosts and demons. Okay. Mm. Once in a while, it may click. But you, suppose, Desmond, if you are reading the book, you will like it only if it evolves some kind of human emotion in you.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, something alien may not excite you that much. So basically, it is more about human emotions. Okay. And these stories, they remain in the mind of the reader. This, like, I'm not speaking because I have written them. No writer is going to tell that his stories are bad. But this is what feedback I got from my readers, that that the stories have, like, they remain in the mind for quite a long period of time.
Oh, okay. So, okay. Understood. Yeah.
Number of stories. So these stories are there, and thankfully I love each one of them, and I hope you read it sometime. And
yes, definitely I am going to read this. So the stories, there are seven stories, you're saying. So this seven stories is something of your imagination, or this is a true story which you have got inspired and you have written?
No, see, none of these stories are true as such, but they are like surely linked with like something in real life. Like, okay, I'll tell you one example. I was in Bangalore, and I'm talking about 1997. Okay, I was student back then, so we used to get like Times of India paper in my flat. Okay, I used to stay with flatmates. And there I read a small piece of news like, okay, that in Hyderabad, a girl jumped into a septic tank and committed suicide.
Oh God.
Okay. The septic tank means the tank of the toilet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I thought that this is a very crude way to commit suicide. I never heard anybody committing suicide by jumping into a septic tank.
Yeah.
Why do you want your death to be so like dirty and so clumsy? I thought that, okay, there are better ways to die. So for 2 to 3 days, I kept on like scanning the papers that no, this cannot be a normal like
death. Suicide. Yeah.
Normal death. It means it cannot be a suicide at all, because nobody is going to jump into a septic tank to do suicide. He can hang himself, he can take poison, or he can do something. So that thing, it stuck into my mind for around about 20 years. And ultimately, one story I have written that in the collection. And I have tried to like imagine what might have happened.
Okay.
So all the stories are like somewhere influenced by something which came across in my life, which I came across. Okay. So these stories are not true, but naturally influenced by.
Influenced by. Yeah. Definitely.
All the stories have some influence in my life.
Definitely, I am going to check it out and I'm going to read it as well. So now, if you can narrate or read few lines, you know, from your book, it will be very helpful for me and for my listeners.
Okay, I'll just read one of my stories. Okay, a paragraph from one of my stories.
Yes.
Until death does us apart. Now, before reading this particular part, I'd like to tell you that this was a challenge given to me by my wife to write a love story.
Okay.
She told me that you cannot write a love story. Okay. Write a love story.
Okay.
And I started writing this story as a love story. But halfway somewhere, okay, I felt, no, I cannot do that. So ultimately, this turned out to be a horror story and one of my favorite stories.
Okay.
Okay, so I read a para. Okay, now my face is fully covered with coin-sized blisters. They itch and burn painfully, but I cannot end my life. Whenever I try to do so, I see Aditi standing beside me. I have not slept a wink since last 5 nights. Every time I try to sleep, I am woken up by a warm, itching sensation somewhere on my body. As I open my eyes, I see her dead body with her eyes open sharing my bed. I know she is not going to leave me, as we had promised each other to stay together until death does us apart. So,
oh my God. I am getting goosebumps right now.
Thanks a lot.
It's beautiful, you know, listening from the, you know, author itself, it is nice. Trust me, it was nice.
Thank you. And this is one of my favorite stories. So whenever you can read it, do read it. And
definitely.
As I'm interacting with you, so now I'm eager to know your response about the book and the stories also.
I will definitely. So now, if someone wants to, you know, buy the book, so where they can buy the book?
The book is easily available on Amazon and as well as Pustak Mandi. Okay. So right now it is not available on Kindle. I think it will come maybe after a month or two. That is how the publishers market the book.
Okay.
At the beginning, the hard copies come.
Hmm.
So Amazon is the best place to buy.
Okay, Amazon is the best place to buy. And when was this book released? Like which month?
This was released on 21st of Jan.
That's nice. Year. Oh, so it's a fresh and new book. Yeah. So for 2021, my listeners, whoever wants to start the year with some amazing reading, you need to check this book out. So now, you know, it was, first of all, it was a lovely narration. So now you take us back to your journey on how you firstly decided to write and how was your journey writing each story. You know, if you can just take us back to your journey.
See, as I told you, Desmond, that I started writing like long back.
Okay. Yeah.
But I never thought it as like a professional way that, okay, let me write something or I should write a book.
Mm-hmm.
Something happened in my life. Suddenly, one day on 14th November 2014, I got an attack of transverse myelitis.
Oh, okay.
And it is a very rare disease.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And my full body was paralyzed. Mm-hmm. Okay. I was not able to move my fingers even. And doctors, they told me that you have one night to live.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
If we are able to save you this night, then you are going to stay for another 10 to 15 years, depending upon like how you recover. And that night, I could not sleep a wink. That thought was coming that what have I done in my life? Okay, and if I die today, then like how is everybody going to remember me? So that night I thought that if I get a life again, then I'm going to write, because writing was like in my, I told you that I used to write.
Correct.
I thought that I'll try to write something big. And luckily, thankfully, by the grace of the Almighty, after struggling for 3 or 4 months, I was out of the hospital, and then slowly, I recovered and I started writing. And in the beginning, I did not have any idea like what to write, how to write. Okay. So I went on writing stories, some murder mysteries, some horror stories. And then once when I completed around about 15 to 20 stories, then I thought that, okay, now it is the time that can I get it published. So luckily I met one literary agent, Mr. Suhail Mathur, and from the Bookmakers Literary Agency. And thankfully he proved to be a godsend mentor for me.
Okay.
And I asked him that, can it be done? Are my stories good enough? So he read the stories and he told that, yeah, we can do it. And thankfully we got the book this month.
That is nice. That's a beautiful, beautiful journey. So before we end the conversation, if you can tell us what is your future plans and, you know, what is your next novel going to be about?
See, actually, this book which I have written, it is not for kids.
Okay.
And as I told you that I teach in a school.
Hmm.
So children generally, they are like very much enthusiastic that, sir, what have you written and what are you writing? So that is why I thought that my next novel should be for children,
okay,
and especially young adults. My next novel is titled Samyanta, and it is basically a mythological historical fiction, and it has got a lot of thrills, and basically the protagonist is a 12-year-old girl. Now many people told me also this, that how can you make a 12-year-old girl a protagonist of the story? Because naturally a 12-year-old child will have his or her own limitations.
Correct.
She cannot go out, she cannot do some daring stuff and all that. Okay, so that was in itself a challenge for me.
That book I am
writing only for my students. For my students means students in general to inculcate the love of reading. And naturally horror is my first love. That is what I am going to write. But the one which I am going to complete is this one, which I tentatively, I feel that in another 3 to 4 months, I'll be able to work it out.
That's nice. And whenever the next novel is out, definitely I'm going to get in touch with you and we will do another episode about that novel, and you know, our listeners can know more about that novel as well. So thank you so much. It was a lovely conversation, you know, and talking about your books, getting to know more about you, and hopefully we should see more books from you. And thank you so much. Well, thanks for listening, and thank you, Mr. Abhishek, for coming on my podcast and talking about your book. May the book be a success, and see you guys next week.